Hello my lovely friends, it's Julia here of EASTCOTT and Burgess Tea. Today we'll talk about the key process which gives birth to the different types of tea and explains why the same tea leaf results in such different flavors. Let's begin. So there are six main types of tea: white tea, green tea, oolong tea, dark tea, black tea and yellow tea. These teas are all so different, and yet they come from the same plant, Camellia sinensis. But the main reason for why a green tea is so different from a black tea is their level of oxidation. So, what is oxidation and how does it change the color, flavor, scent, and health benefits and chemical properties of the leaf? Oxidation is when compounds in the tea leaf juices react with air, causing the flavor of the leaf to change and the leaf to darken in color. An example of this that we see in our everyday life is when we cut an apple open and it turns brown with time. Similarly, when a leaf is exposed to oxygen in the air, a chemical reaction occurs causing the leaf to change. The first step of the reaction looks like this. During oxidation, the antioxidants catechins, which are a reduced type of polyphenol, as chemists would call them, are converted to an oxidized state polyphenol in the presence of oxygen, light, and enzymes, such as PPO, which is an enzyme naturally present in the tea leaf. This leads to a chain of reactions, the final step of which produces theophylline, which are an oxidized type of antioxidants and which contribute to the red color of black tea. All this means that depending on the oxidation level of the tea leaf will have a different color, scent, and chemical properties. This is why different types of tea need to be brewed differently, because they all contain different compounds which are released at different temperatures and different brewing times. I have spent a lot of time experimenting with different temperatures and brewing times, and I've summarized my findings in a free guide I've created on this. If you'd like to see my recommendations for the different temperatures and brewing times for different teas, I will leave a link to my guide in the description below. Firstly, since oxygen is one of the main contributors to oxidation, in order to increase the interaction of the polyphenols with the oxygen, we want to damage the leaf and to break the cell walls. This process also mixes the polyphenols with the enzymes naturally present in the leaf, thus speeding up oxidation. Damaging the cell wall is called initiation in tea production and can be achieved by tearing the leaf, rolling the leaf, or even shaking the leaf to achieve a gentler oxidation. Secondly, oxidation in the tea leaf is encouraged by the presence of enzymes which are naturally occurring in the leaf, such as a one called PPO for short. When this enzyme is damaged, the process of oxidation is slowed down. This is beneficial during production of green tea and white teas, which are less oxidized than, say, black teas. This enzyme begins being damaged and denatured, as chemists call it, at around 60 degrees Celsius or 150 degrees Fahrenheit. This damaging of the enzyme is called fixing in tea production and can be achieved by applying heat. So in Chinese teas, this would be when the tea is dried or pan roasted. And in Japanese teas, this can be achieved by steaming, for example. From the scientific studies I've seen, it seems that the higher you heat the tea, the more the enzyme is deactivated. Meaning that in white teas, which are sun-dried, the enzyme may be more active than in green tea, which is treated at a higher temperature. This is why the method of oxidation matters. So sun drying will result in white tea, whereas pan roasting will result in a green tea. So to conclude, today we've learned one of the key reasons why the same leaf can result in such different types of tea. But oxidation is not the only reason why the same leaf can result in such different types of tea. Next week we'll find out what the other reasons are. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please check out my website with more information like this one on tea. Check out my brewing guide down below this video if you want to get the best flavors out of your tea. Like this video, share and subscribe. Delicious with Julia signing off, and I'll see you again next week. Ciao!